Hello and welcome back to the channel Smartekey. Let's go over the actual concept, like what exactly that data lake is. Nothing but a centralized repository that allows you to store all kind of structured and unstructured data. At any scale, right? So we can store any kind of massive volume of data into the data lake, where it can be structured, it may be in unstructured form. So that those can be stored in the data lake, right? Store data as is without having to first structure the data, right? So some of the time when we are really using some RDBMS system, or maybe if you talk about some data warehouse, so what we have to do is really massage the data and clean the data, and we have to transform, I would say, from a unstructured data structure to a structured way of storing the data, right? Otherwise we can't store JSON formatted data into a tabular format, right, as is. So that we have to make a massage on that, and then we can store into the data warehouse or maybe some RDBMS data store, and also run different types of analytics for dashboards and visualizations. And other than that, also we can do the big data processing, real-time analytics, and machine learning as well. So these are the very important points where we can really define what exactly the data lake is. So on that note, if we talk about data lake, then this is how the data lake would look like. Right. So in one side, we can say there are the data sources, and next we'll see the data lake, and the other side we'll find all those analytics stuffs. Right. So now data sources would be like networks, maybe endpoints, cloud applications, users, maybe some IoT stuff, and any other thing. Right.
So this is just a gist about data lake, but for more in-depth concept, I would recommend please visit my other video, which really talks about the data lake and data lake concept, and what exactly it's used for, all those things. So that will be that will give you a better idea about the data lake and how you really start up.
Note, when we're jumping on the traditional data lake, so every company, every organization, whoever is data intensive, and they are mostly playing on the data, and most of the most of the companies, they really are really hurtling into the this kind of architecture pattern when they are building the data lake. So it's straightforward. There are three parts. One is capturing the data, and other part is the storing the data, and third one is delivering the data, right? So the one thing is how people really really capture the data, right? These things will talk about a little bit in that. And when we are talking about the capturing capturing data, so in the sense we already saw there are lots of multiple data sources from where we can really capture the data, right? So once we know this is the source, either we can write our own producers or maybe own ingestion process to ingest the data from any of the data source to the data lake. So, I mean, data sources can be any third-party CSV files, streaming events, so any kind of data source, right? So, when we are trying to ingest the data to the data lake, so it can be any kind of collect process or producer process, right? So we can collect it, transform if you want, and partition it and route the data to the right data lake, right? So now once data is available in the data lake, so we know like it's in a unstructured format or semi-structured format, or maybe some of them are structured format, right? So definitely not necessarily all the data is in structured format, right? So once data is stored into our data lake, then it's a one-stop shop. Right, so all the data, every kind of data is now available in data lake. So now, anyone can extract the data from here, right? Some of the organization or some of the, architects, what they used to do is they build some of the other tooling system, catalog system around the data lake where, in virtually, that will consider as a structured way of accessing the data. Right, but under the hood, the data is not at all structured, right? So that data has to be catalog in the sense like, okay, that has to be defined which data is for what, right? Otherwise, it's just a mess of data, or it's just a some set of data but without any meaning, right? So build the catalog, define the schema around that, and you'll try to version the schema, right? Version the schema, or maybe versioning the data set, right? So you have to version it out so that anytime it's getting deleted or anytime it's getting updated or overridden, so you should have the way to really, go back to the history and see like what changes happened to that data set, right? So that has to be there. And definitely inventory of the data to a target destination. So you have to define, one way we have defined push the data into data lake. So there in the capture state we did that, and when we are storing and trying to deliver the data to a different destination, so we need to apply all these cataloging and loading mechanism to around the data lake, so that will be the data will be treated in a good manner, in the sense like, and some defined purpose rather than it just a mess of data set. So once those things prepare and perform, then the data from the data lake is ready to consume, right? So then the consumer side will come in the picture. So that is nothing but the deliver side of house, right? So the deliver is nothing but the rapid insights and business results from all data, right? So destination could be any, right? We can store that data into some data warehouse, or we can store that data Elastic server, or we can that can be pulled and sent to some visualization system for the analytics purpose, right? So that can be done. So destinations could be data is loaded to a target destination. It can be database, tables and schema, or as we say, like any caching system or anything, right, where we can send the data in a structured manner, right? And then from there, any of the downstream team or any downstream application, they can really consume those data to do their own work, right? So when talking about all these things, we need to also think about like what could be go wrong, right? When we are really designing the thing in a very professional manner, or maybe this will definitely scalable. It would be definitely very easy to flow the data from one end to other. But what could be go wrong, right? So definitely, we would say like As you say, like software frameworks that distributes data storage and processing among commodity hardwares located in on-premise data centers. Okay, Hadoop includes a file system called HDFS, right, that enables a customer to store data in its native form, right? So the ecosystem also includes open source equivalent to the SQL, we are saying, like, right, structured query language, the standard language used to communicate with a database, right, along with the batch and interactive data processing technologies, right? So cluster management utility and other necessary data platforms components, right? On that note, so that's great. That thank you so much for visiting the channel, and please share and subscribe the channel. Bye and take care for now. See you then.